Good morning. Welcome to Frank's School. 148th day of the fifth year, and I've got this not these numbers right now. I'm pretty sure they're right. They were off by one a little bit ago. Describing a trip I made to Switzerland, the first time I ever saw the Alps. This is the third prequel up to the letter G. I'll be rather brief today, actually, even though this was an incredible drive, unforgettable, really. And why I'm doing it is a prequel to get you ready before I give you my best shot at the best itinerary I can give you for my kind of trip, anyway, to Europe. I've been to, we stayed the night in Martigny, and then we drove. There is a Well, I'll tell you some of this stuff in much more detail when I describe what I think maybe you should do. I've been up through the Valais, which is the name of this long, really long, fairly straight, narrow valley. Longest and deepest in Europe, I said. I think that's true. I've been up through that four times in my life. The second time, I was also driving. And I mention that just briefly because that time, my wife and I, my wife of now and I, rented a car in Geneva and drove up toward Mont Blanc through France. And then, for some reason, I cannot think of the name of that little town. The Olympics were held there, right at the foot of Mont Blanc. You can't see very well. That was quite a drive because you're going up these waterfalls or leaping off cliffs. That was something too. But in any, I'm telling you because as we approached Le Valais, we didn't do it from the Rhone, from the Lake Geneva side. We went over a pass where La Forclaz, I think it's La Forclaz Glacier, is up there. If there's anything left of it now, I suspect it's maybe melted away by now. Went over a pass and stayed in a little town called Fenho. Finhaut, Finhaut. Got up there, tired because we'd flown in and all that. So, and then we drove down to Martigny, and that is a fine way. If you were to rent a car, that's a fine way to approach Le Valais and Martigny, as long as you're not afraid of driving. There might have been guardrails on that road. Actually, took a group of students on that it would have been the third time that I went up through Valais. I was traveling with a small group and we got the postal bus and took the bus up to La Forclaz Glacier and then the bus back down. I think there might even be guardrails there. All right, anyway, and while I'm at it, I've been to Switzerland 8 or 9 times. When I used to take students on tours, I thought, there's no way I'm going to go to Europe and not go through the Alps. I mean, that's important. I felt that was important. The route, we went to the real major cities and all, but always the Alps. And I actually had forgotten how well I know Switzerland. I've studied it so much. I've often told people I know it better than Pennsylvania, which is a state where I live. And that's probably actually true. I know Switzerland really well, and it's from all that studying and the times I've been there, and my interest in the place. And it's tempting to launch into a story about Switzerland, tell you all about Switzerland, but that's not my purpose right now, and I don't think it even will be when I give you a detailed itinerary. I don't think. If I were traveling with you, I would tell you all this stuff I knew as we travel. Or maybe sometime, maybe next year, if I go on to teach in French school, maybe I'll devote a whole big chunk to Switzerland because there is a country worth study, and I have studied it a lot and know a lot about it. Well, anyway, what we did was we drove from Martigny up the valley. Now, from the bottom of the valley, you can't see as much as you can if you can get up the valley walls a little bit. But I don't think we didn't do that again. We just drove up the valley because time was a little short. We had to cover a lot of ground. We kept going up. We went past Brig, Fiesch, There was one stop that we made, and it must have been a good ways up the valley by now, because there were cows there. It was the first time I'd ever been around a pasture where there were cows with bells, and hearing that sound of cowbells echoing around in, at that point, it was really quite narrow. So I think we were getting pretty high. And then eventually we went over the Furka Pass. That's where the Rhone Glacier is, and I'm pretty sure it's still there, parts of it. You can actually go in it. We did not do that, not that time. I did it later. But we went over the Furka Pass, and I mean this stuff is on YouTube. I mean, if you had any interest in it or you wanted to see it, all this stuff, I'm sure you can see it easily on YouTube. But anyway, we went over the Furka Pass, and then we got in some tremendous rainstorm. A puddle of water drowned out the engine, and it stopped. And I remember some guy in a raincoat. He was out there almost like a policeman or something. I don't know. It was already dark, and he pushed us and got us going again. And then we headed on. And before, that might have been in a little tiny village called Realp. I don't know how you pronounce it, but I don't think we went very much further. I think it was the next village. I'm guessing Ospital. Again, I'm not, this time I'm not, I don't know if that's exactly what it was, or if I've even got it spelled right. But there we spent the night. We did not get as far as Andermatt, which would have been a more likely place to stop. The things that I mean, from this day of driving, this whole experience was absolutely formative. But I can't pick single experiences out that were so formative for me, other than I was driving through the most beautiful, second most beautiful place on earth that I had seen. I do remember how delightful the girl was that was like the waitress, I guess you'd call it, where we stayed in that, I think it was. She just seemed like such a happy person. I thought, well, maybe it's because she lives here. But by now we were out of the Valais. We had gone over the Rhone Glacier, the Furka Pass, and we were heading down the other side. All right, I really only have, I think, about one more day. To tell you about this prequel. Maybe a day in a little bit. Bye for now.